your future. My last question to you today, and it's always the last question with every guest I have, is, as you know, I mentioned there was a bunch of students out of Ukraine. We launched the effort to help support small business of Ukraine by providing working capital for bakeries and many other small companies that will give this goods and services for free to the people. So I know you're in Kyiv, and please talk about how critical it is to support small business now in Ukraine, because in my view, that's what drives the economy anywhere. And in Ukraine, it's critical, sure, not just for emergency purposes as well, in addition to the future economy.
Well, yeah, I mean, you know, listen, I mean, it's kind of an old trope to say that, you know, that the economy is underpinned by small and medium-sized enterprises. It's certainly true. I mean, one of the things I certainly ascribe to try to be is a good employer. I mean, first and foremost, I want CDM to be a good place to work, and be enjoyable, and take that more sustainable, you know, sort of pragmatic approach to how I've built the company. But yeah, I mean, we create jobs. I mean, this is just it. And you're seeing it now, right? Jobs generate tax dollars. Taxes finance the war. They finance infrastructure. They finance all those things. So when you're hiring Ukrainians through small and medium enterprises, you're contributing to the state in a number of ways. You know, this is something that I've talked with you about on my attitudes in terms of how the country is structured, how it can do more to support small and medium enterprises. That conversation probably isn't finished. I can tell you.
Small and medium-sized business have a great opportunity now to connect with much bigger companies and become their local partners. And we want to support them now during the war with donations from around the world, simply for them to stay in business, because we know it's much easier to stay in business than to close the doors and then try to restart it.
Yeah, yeah. I mean, this is going to be a challenge for every small and medium enterprise. I mean, we've got right now a sustainable pattern for CDM. You know, we are reconstituting slowly in terms of, you know, employment and getting back on our feet and getting back to work. I think June, July will be the toughest months.
Yep.
I mean, there's reasons for that. I mean, you know, it's like everybody, okay, some folks can go a certain distance without, you know, regular income, but it's always limited. That's true for people. That's true for companies. You know, there's a reason we have to circulate cash flow stop, unfortunately.
And this is why the orders we're talking about from American companies now coming in and say, hey, we want to build something. We're willing to put some money in to engage the people to do the back, you know, the bottom, you know, the work that needs to be done on the ground. It's critical now during the war because those people are employed. They get money to feed their families and so on. So then, Dan, I want to thank you so much. I want to thank you for such a big passion for Ukraine, for all the work you've done, and all the work we'll do together with you. Thank you, Dan.
Thank you as well, Henry. Happy to be a part of this.
Yes, and everybody, please support our show, support Ukraine, and we'll see you soon with the next guest.